the resurrection and the life, says the Lord. Those who believe in me, even though they die, will live. And everyone who lives and believes in me will never die. The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His mercies never come to an end. They are new every morning. Great is his faithfulness. Do please be seated. A warm welcome to you all to St. Edmund's Church this afternoon for Leslie's funeral service. After our time here in church, Leslie's committal will take place at Hutcliffe Wood Crematorium. And although the current restrictions mean that that time is family only, I know that many other people will travel there with you in their thoughts and their prayers. Should you wish to leave a donation in Leslie's memory, there's a collection plate at the back of church, and all donations will be shared between the British Heart Foundation and the Scottish Terrier Emergency Care. We meet in the name of Jesus Christ, who died and was raised to the glory of God the Father. Grace and peace be with you all. We have come here today to remember before God our brother Les, to give thanks for his life, to commend him to God, our loving Redeemer and Judge, to commit his body to be cremated, and to comfort one another in our grief. I didn't know Les, but I know from what's been said to me that you will come here, obviously with much pain and sorrow, but I know too that you will come with thanksgiving for all that you have shared with Les and all that he will continue to be for you through his memories. So let's begin our worship by offering to God in prayer all of those mixed feelings that we bring with us now. Let's pray. Almighty God, you judge us with infinite love and justice, and love everything that you have made. In your love, turn the darkness of death into the dawn of new life, and the sorrow of parting into the joy of heaven, through our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen. We're going to hear tributes now from the family, please.
Dad, he was a gentleman. He loved us unconditionally and he loved our mum with all his heart. We grew up feeling loved, safe and happy within our, both our family and with our aunts, uncles and cousins. Dad would do anything for us and often did, taking us where we needed to go as children. Football, weights, weeks, events, when we were attendants, majorettes, etc. And then later when we got older, picking us up from different venues, pubs, clubs, etc. We also fondly remember our annual holidays to Scarborough. 1 week every year without fail, with Dad talking about coming home as he drove us to Scarborough, and the three of us shouting at him saying, "We haven't even got there yet, Dad." He was always in a rush, as you all know that. Mum always asked our Gran if Dad had been born in a hurry, because everything always had to be done at high speed, and that never changed, as any of his friends in the village will be able to confirm. Because whenever they saw him walking or racing through the village, eating his apple, he more often than not talked to them as he was still moving, even up to the day before going to the hospital. Dad liked to talk, and if anyone got in a queue next to him, or on the bus, or in a shop, then by the time they got to where they were going, they would know Dad's life story, and ours. We were proud that he was always the same, the one that stood up to thank someone at an event, golf or otherwise, if you thought that thanks would be given. Dad always tried to keep up with the latest ideas, and Granville will never forget the time Dad had heard that speed walking was good for you, and despite them both being over 80, decided him and Mum should try and Suffice to say, Grandal had to pick it himself up off the floor from Latin when they took it in turns to speed walk past our house. They had to go one at a time as they had their last beloved Scotty dog, Robbie, with them at the time. They both loved their Scotties and over the years adopted quite a few from the Scottish Terrier Emergency Care Scheme. After Mum passed away, he took her place with the girls at the Peak Quiz on a Thursday night and enjoyed a glass or two of red wine. He always said he had a glass of red wine or two at night with just a little bit of dark chocolate, his favourites. Like all of you, we have so many memories of our dad to share. But because of COVID, we were not allowed to get together to reminisce at the moment. But when COVID restrictions allow, we will be having a get-together to celebrate his life in a way that he would have wanted and invite all his family and friends. And I'm sure my dad would be first in the queue.
These are some words that I'm reading on behalf of Blaise's family. Blaise was born in Eadsfold in Castleton to Fred and Ethel Robinson. The first of three children, he was actually born on his dad's birthday on the 12th of August in 1932. He was followed by his sister and then his baby brother Tony. He went to Castleton Primary School, although on his first day he went home at lunchtime as he thought school was over. But his dad had to take me back. After primary school, Les was awarded a special place at New Mills Grammar School. He was also a cub, and then a scout, and later became assistant scoutmaster. He joined Castleton Band in 1945 and played in the band on and off until 1963. His first job was an assistant designer in a drawing office before he moved on to do his national service in the RAF, where he trained as an airframe mechanic and was then seconded to the drawing office. He would talk about his many wonderful memories, including playing in two RAF bands, flying in a Lancaster, a Tiger Moth and a Meteor 7. But the highlight, he always said, was the New Year's dance in 1951 at RAF Leckenfield, because that's when he met the lady who was become a lover of his wife, Barbara Rose. Les worked at Blue Circle for over 35 years, retiring as cashier at 55. He was also involved in the Hope Show for 20 years, being both treasurer and secretary during this time. Les and Barbara married and settled in Hope. They had three children, Philip, Catherine and Helena. And Les was proud of his children and their partners, Kay Neal and Granville. And he and Barbara couldn't have been more happy than when their grandchildren, Emma and Richard, came along. After being asked by his brother-in-law, Brian Taylor, he joined Thornsett Band playing euphonium and enjoyed playing in the band for over 10 years. And later in the service, we will hear a solo from Brian. Les enjoyed family life and always stayed close to his sister and brother-in-law, Anne and Brian. And although they passed away far too early, he always remained very close to his nieces, Susan, Joanne and Gillian, and their families. He also stayed close to his brother Tony and his wife Anne and his nieces Julie and Paula and their families, enjoying family birthdays and golfing whenever they could. And apparently he was really, really pleased when waiting outside Tony's golf club, somebody mistook him for Tony, his younger brother. Now we know Les enjoyed his golf. He started playing in 1954 and played regularly at Hope Works Golf Club and was secretary, captain and president over the years. Les and Barbara treasured their memories of many happy golfing holidays with their friends. He joined Capel Honorifith Golf Club in 1986 and only really stopped playing golf in the last couple of years. However, he still enjoyed playing snooker with his friends at Chapel and was still able to play thanks to Kendale, who would pick him up and take him once he could no longer drive to the onset of epilepsy in 2019. Les left his beloved Barbara in September 2015. He struggled with her loss, but he had all his family, many friends who helped him to feel less lonely over the last few years, including his golden girls, Sandra, Val and Maureen. He loved taking them out for coffee and shopping, and it helped him a lot, as did continuing to go out for coffee and cake with Jean Wilkie, a long-time friend of Barbara's. He also kept busy by auditing the books for friends of Castleton, Hope and Edel schools and Perivale Players up until very recently, and was still doing his crossword every day despite his epilepsy. A lot of people have said that they will miss seeing Les doing his regular walk through the village, and all of the ASD family have said it will not be the same without him popping his head in to say hello and tell them what he was getting up to every day. Les will be loved and missed by all his family and friends. He's now reunited forever with Barbara. I'm going to try and read a short poem that Tony has written for him. I'm not sure I can. Come on, Tony, can we give it a go? You may not even give it a go.
You went away so suddenly, we didn't say goodbye. But brothers can never be parted, precious memories never die. Until we meet again, we'll think about you always. We think about you still. We hold you close within our hearts, and there you will remain until we meet.
Thank you all for those wonderful tributes. It's a very hard thing to do, but I'm sure that you will have stirred some of those really special memories for all of us here. So thank you. Now we're going to hear our Bible reading. We're going to hear some words of Jesus from John's Gospel. Do not let your hearts be troubled. You believe in God. Believe also in me. My Father's house has many rooms. If that were not so, would I have told you that I'm going there to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back and take you to be with me, so that you also may be where I am. You know the way to the place where I am going. Thomas said to him, Lord, we don't know where you're going, so how can we know the way? Jesus answered, I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. If you really know me, you will know my Father as well. From now on, you do know him and have seen him. Those words from John's Gospel are a popular choice at funerals, because they are Jesus' words to disciples who were probably feeling very much as you are feeling today. Jesus had told them he was going to die, and they were feeling lost and anxious and wondering how they were going to face the future. Do not let your hearts be troubled, Jesus tells them. And he goes on to assure them that in the end, they will not be separated from him. In the end, they will be with him in his Father's house, which has many rooms. In Jesus' day, houses only had one room, which was the living space for the whole family. To the disciples, many rooms must surely have meant many families, many people, many different family traditions and customs, all different, yet all belonging to God. I'm sure this passage assures us that there is no long list of boxes to tick to get into heaven. Thomas had the courage to ask the questions that we all ask from time to time. How can we be sure we're going there? How will we get there? And again, Jesus reassures him, I am the way. You know the way I have lived, loving everyone, talking to anyone and everyone, caring about others. That's the way to get to my Father's house. And you don't need to worry about exactly how it happens, because I will sort that. Those words of reassurance for the disciples are words of reassurance for us too. God's house is our eternal home too. In a moment, we're going to hear some music and then I'll lead us in our prayers. But as we listen to our next piece of music, I'm going to invite you, even in the midst of your grief, to sit with your own favourite memories of Les, knowing that as we do so, we can trust God for Les's safe homecoming and for ours. And so now we're going to listen to the music. Let's pray. God of love, Lord of life, You have made us in your own image, to reflect your truth and light. We give you thanks for Les, for the grace and love he received from you and shared with us, for all that was good in his life and the memories that we treasure today. Especially we thank you for his place in our community here, for how he brightened lives with his daily walks, and for his great love for his family. God of hope, we come to you in grief and shock and confusion of heart. Help us to find peace in the knowledge of your love, and give us light to guide us out of darkness. We pray for Philip, for Catherine and Helena, for Kay, Neil and Woody, for Les's grandchildren, Emma and Richard, for Tony and Anne, and Les's nieces, Paula and Julie, Susan, Joanne and Gillian, and their partners and families, for Edith, Alan and Sharon, and all Les's family and friends, for all those who knew Les and loved him and mourn with us today. Surround them with your love, that they may not be overwhelmed by their loss, but have confidence in your goodness and strength to meet the days to come. God of love, entrusting into your hands all that you have made, and rejoicing in our communion with all your people, we make our prayers through Jesus Christ, our Saviour. Amen. So now let us gather all our prayers spoken and those spoken in the silence of our hearts into one in the words of the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. Will you please stand as we commend Les to God, his heavenly Father and ours. Let us commend Les to the loving goodness of God, our Maker and our Redeemer. Les, go forth on your journey from this world in the love of God the Father who created you, in the peace of Jesus Christ who redeemed you, in the power of the Holy Spirit who strengthens you. May the heavenly hosts surround you and the whole company of heaven enfold you, and may you dwell this day and forevermore in God's eternal peace. Amen. Do please be seated. And now, to him who is able to keep us from falling and lift us from the dark valley of despair to the bright mountain of hope, from the midnight of death to the daybreak of joy, to him be power and authority for ever and ever. Amen. And now may Christ, the Good Shepherd, enfold you with his love, fill you with his peace, and lead you in hope to the end of your days. And may the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, be with you all, and with all those you love, and remain with you always. Amen.